Bethany Bernasconi. I am a parent of two young men, a third grader and a sixth grader. I am the 2012 New Hampshire Teacher of the Year, and I am the Dean of Instruction at Amherst Middle School. I'm really excited to have the opportunity to come here today and share a story with you. I thought a lot about what can I say in 5 minutes? What can I say that might have some influence, might have a story to take with you in all the important deliberations that you'll have over the course of this year and those years to come in regards to the most important vocation, which we all have, and that's the education of New Hampshire school children. It's my honor to share the story of our community in Amherst. And I say community of learners, and that includes our students, our teachers, our administrators, our school board, our parents, and our community at large. We've been fortunate over the past couple of years to be part of the New Hampshire PACE program and have really been able to use this opportunity as a lever of change in our school. When we began the process, you know, as so many times in education, there are so many initiatives, so many tasks ahead of us, so many endeavors, and too often we're trying to fix the plane while we're flying it and navigating the course. So we always try to start with the why. What is it that we want? I asked my teachers last year, what is it that we want for our students? What is it that we want for our children? Because parents entrust us with their children. Many times they spend more hours with us than they do with anyone else. What is it that we want? And let's start there. That has to be our why. That has to be the center of every decision we make, whether it's at a policy level, whether it's at a building level, or whether it's in the classroom. And we came up with a list of things that we want for our children. We want them to be good communicators. We want them to love learning. We want them to have every door open. We want their journey to be long and winding and have every pathway available to them. We want them to fall in love with science or literature or mathematics or the arts. And the question then laid before us, how do we do that? And our answer was really examining our practices and looking at teaching and learning in the classroom. And performance assessments and the work and support of the New Hampshire PACE pilot has allowed us to do that. It has been a lever of change. The conversations have been so rich and so meaningful. We're moving away from, and we finally have the tools, the skills, and the ability to really move away from that skill and drill style learning. We want our students to be able to apply learning in new and meaningful ways. And looking and reevaluating with performance assessment is the way that we've done that. You know, too many times we hear the word assessment and we think, oh, that's the end game. And it was said earlier in one of the comments today that assessment is really just the beginning for us. It has been the tool to say, what do we want students to do at the end? How do we want them to be able to apply their learning? And then all of our instruction has stemmed from that. It has changed the way we do things. Lessons have moved to be more and more student-centered, project-based learning. What the tools of PACE have allowed us to do is to take that project-based learning and really increase the cognitive rigor of what we're doing to make sure it's developmentally appropriate for our children and that it's authentic. Because we know that real learning only happens when it's authentic. That holds true for our students, but that also holds true for our teachers. And so I want to take just a few minutes I have to talk about what this has meant for teachers. The support that we've gained through collaborations with the Department of Education and PACE as a Tier 2 school, we're not even to the point where this work has alleviated us of any burden of testing, and it has already had deep and lasting impacts in our classrooms with students and with teachers. The conversations that are had, the language that teachers are using, the tools they now have available through training and partnerships with the Department of Ed, the Center for Collaborative Education, and now bringing that work back has created avenues for teacher leadership in our school, has created professional learning communities, has created venues where teachers are talking about calibrating student work, talking about grading, talking about what the purpose of grades are and how do we communicate and partner better and better with our local community to really help move all students forward. This has been an incredible opportunity for our school. It's my sincerest hope that more schools have the opportunity to take advantage of this great learning because all of our students, no matter what corner of New Hampshire we hail from, deserve the very best. At the end of the day, it is hard work that we are engaged in. And I think, and I would welcome you to come and talk to any teacher or any student in our school, but they'll tell you that it is the work that matters. because our students don't get a do-over. They don't get a retake on this day. This is the best day they will have. Today is precious. It's a gift. The learning they achieve today is a gift. And we've been able to use our work with PACE and our collaborations to really make it the best moments of learning possible. So I encourage you to continue this good work, continue these partnerships, expand wherever possible. Right now, we are in the midst of SBAC like so many others, and this will eventually give us the gift of time back in the classroom for authentic and curriculum-based assessment. Thank you for your work, and I hope that many others have a chance to participate in this good work as well. Thank you.